Okay, so what I'd like to do is set up the scene and camera, kind of do them in conjunction together. So I'm just going to select our container object or the room that we're in and tab into edit mode. And I'm just going to press 7 and 5 for top or graphic. And I'm just going to add some edge loops. So control R, just roll the mouse wheel to get 2 and left click twice and just scale these along the X. Just drag them out to the corner and control R and just 2 more running along the X axis and scale these on the Y. Just drag them out to the corner. I want to add some light material out here. So I'm going to press control tab and just switch to face selection. Select these 4 faces and come over to my material. I'm just going to rename this to room for lack of a better name. Just press enter and I'm just going to add a new material slot and just select that room material and just click the plus and just select this and just rename it to lights. Okay, and with the light selected, I'm just going to come down here to my node editor and just delete that diffuse and press shift A. And under shader, I want to add an emission. Just plug that in. I'm just going to choose a blue color and maybe turn the strength up to 15 for the moment. Okay, I can just drag this down out of my way. I can press T and N just to give me some room. I'm going to press 1 and I'm just going to press Z for wireframe. And just tab back to object mode and control alt 0. Okay, that just snaps the camera to the 3D view that I was just in. So I'm just going to select the camera and press G and Y and zoom this out, maybe something like this. And then just press G and drag this down here. I'm just going to frame up the car. So G and Y, something like this, and frame it up. Okay, so what I want to do is just add a constraint for the camera so we can rotate around and focus on the center of the car at all times. So to do that, shift S and just make sure the cursor is at center. Shift A, I'm going to add an empty, plane axis empty. And I'm just going to come up to the outliner. Just press the full stop while I'm hovering here and that'll jump to my empty. I'm just going to rename this to camera constraint, press enter. And I'm going to select the camera, press and hold shift and select the empty. And it's important that the camera is selected first and then the empty. I'm going to press control T and make track options. So damp track constraint is what I want. Okay, and I'm just going to select the empty again and just drag this up so we can just align the camera a little bit better. I'll just drag up the camera. Okay, so now with the cursor still at center, I'm just going to press the full stop and choose 3D cursor. And if I select the camera now and press RZ, you can see that we can rotate right around the car. So just right click to snap that back. And what I'm going to do is just press Z and bring up render. And I'm just going to select the camera. And now you can just press R and I'm just going to restrict it to the Z and just rotate around here. Just fix a position. Press G, can push forward and we can come up at an angle. So you have loads of control with the track 2 constraint. Okay, I think that's going to do it for this one.